Welcome, welcome, welcome. Welcome back to another exciting, bittersweet, not bittersweet, happy, good time of a guide. Oh, God bless, can I speak? Welcome back to another episode, our season finale. Yay. Of season 3 of A Guide to Poor Parenting podcast, where me, Jason.
And me, Jennifer.
Have a few drinks.
And talk shit about our kids.
Please follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Guide to Poor Parenting. And wait, is that? That's not right. That's the old one.
Oh.
And Twitter, it's shit, whatever it is. It's on the description in the podcast.
And this is how season 3 ends.
Yes, this is because I copied the outline I copied from season 2 and didn't pay attention to what I was doing. So, So, Miss Jennifer, it's the end of season 3.
Yay.
Can you believe we've made it this far?
I mean, yeah, because we like to talk.
Yeah, that's true. And we like to drink.
That's right.
And we've got a lot of shit to talk about our kids.
Yes, definitely. I like that we do this and thinking that we've already done as many episodes as we have is kind of like, whoa. Because, I know we do it, like, you know, pretty much on the weekends. But when you count them up, it's like, okay.
Yeah, Jennifer and I were talking about what we were going to talk about for this podcast. And I was like, well, why don't we go back and look at, you know, the episodes. And I'm like, you know, we have, I thought it would tell me how many I have. I know we have over 60 episodes.
Yep.
So
that's a lot.
It is a lot.
And it's just a lot of talking and drinking.
And just like for two friends sitting around shooting the shit. I mean, you know, when I first started this, I kept seeing videos about making your own podcast. And they're like, if you can make it past 8, you're doing good. So
the fact we've made it way past.
Yeah, we are way past 8. Have you had a good, what did you think of the season? Did you have fun?
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely had fun.
Yeah, I did too.
It was a good one.
I feel like we got, like, because this season, like, the first 2 seasons, I think we were doing, if I remember correctly, we were doing 1 solo per 1 interview, and we were doing...
I don't remember
either. But I do know for this season, we were doing 2 solos per every 1 interview, and it worked out well, just because we're, you know, like, we're fucking parents, and it's
right
hard sometimes, and Kiki will show up unannounced, and we're like, oh, I guess we're not recording today, because I've got 2 little monsters running around being loud. And Kiki and Kalia are loud as AF.
Yes.
So, but I think it's been a lot of fun. How's your week been, Miss Jennifer?
It was okay, but yesterday made up for it as good because my youngest sister got married and we got to celebrate her and her husband.
Congratulations. And,
just had a good time just hanging out with family and, you know, doing that sort of thing. So that was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
I'm paying for it today, definitely, but that's okay.
How's the injured hoof doing?
I should have been out of the boot, 3 weeks ago tomorrow? But, I'm still in the boot.
I'm wondering if he's just going to tell you to take it off and push through the pain.
Well, I called, I have to call Walgreens because I called and told them I didn't think the gabapentin was working that has many milligrams as I had. Mm-hmm. Just, I couldn't. It doesn't
like, do anything help anymore.
Yeah. Well, the thing is I was taking it at night. And with all the other sleep medicines I take at night, I mean, I was like, yeah, that works good, you know. But during the day when I don't really take any other stuff, but like my ADHD medicine, I don't feel a difference in the pain.
Yeah.
And that's what I told her. And I asked them to get me a physical therapy appointment. Just one. Because I want to see what I have to do to... Because I can't bend. Like, I can wiggle my big toe, but I can't bend it.
Yeah.
And I've tried, like, trying Force to pull it down. And I was like, I don't know if I'm supposed to do this, but I can't make it go down either.
Yeah.
Like, and I don't want to, like, break my toe because I'm pulling too hard down, you know.
But it's
like,
you got a titanium rod. You can't break it anymore.
No, it's not in my toe, though. It's at the base of my, like, near my ankle.
Yeah.
But I'm just like, I want someone to show me how far I can push myself because I don't want to sit there and not push myself hard enough thinking I am or push myself too hard and hurt myself. So let a professional show me one time and that'll be it because I don't want to, you know, do the time or the money that it takes to do physical therapy. So.
Good old American healthcare. And
yep.
It's like, I remember our friend Cody had his knee replaced and you know, he was a broke student. You were paying for him for everything. And he was like really struggling to make those physical therapy appointments. But, mm-hmm. you know, if we were in England or in France, be like, oh, just go to physical therapy and your company has to honor it or else. Here, you're just like, well, fuck you.
Yeah.
Hope you can walk.
Yeah.
Motherfucker.
But yeah, so.
So sister right. number two. So your eldest sister, she got married nope. 2 years ago? Oh, no. Poochie's the oldest, right? Yep. Okay.
Yeah. So we'll, the middle one got married 3 years ago.
But her husband passed. Yep. And then, so this is the youngest.
This is the youngest. Yep. She got married and I think she had a good time.
I hope so. The dress you wore was very pretty. Yeah. Jennifer brought it over. She's like, can you alter it, please? So yes. We've got the sewing machine. And
yes, because I bought it off of the Amazons and the slit was almost to my panty line. Yeah. On both sides.
And Jennifer's a tall, drink-a lady.
I am very white-legged lady, and I did not want to show that much white leg to people.
You didn't want to put on pantyhose?
I mean, even, like, through, I mean, you know, I would have had to go buy some, because, you know, I don't wear, you know, dresses often. But, yeah, I was just like, hey, fix it, please.
Yeah, luckily it was a pretty easy fix.
Yeah.
And it looked, I think you look really nice in it.
Well, I mean, everybody... I mean, I got lots of compliments.
Yeah.
A lot of people taking pictures because, you know, might have been their first time seeing me in a dress kind of thing. So, you know.
Yeah.
But, yeah. I had that made my week good.
Good.
Because of yesterday. How has your week been?
My week has been okay. I finally had my, like, quarterly appointment with my doctor for blood pressure and, you know, because I just have to... for updates with my blood pressure and cholesterol medication.
Yeah.
But I've late in the last like 3 months, especially, I just feel like I'm blowing up. I'm having a hard time containing my appetite. And so I was like, can we do something? I was like, I know these semaglutide, you know, the Wegovy and Ozempic and all that shit. And so I was like, can I get on one, please? She's like, I can try. It's kind of up to your insurance. So she put in the prescription. And I had done, it was about a year ago, I think. I there's a med spa here in town, and they were offering compounded semaglutide, which is the ingredient in Ozempic, mm-hmm. I think. And so I was like, well, you know, I tried it, and it worked really well. I started losing weight, but it is, you know, at the end, it was like $400 a month. And I was like, I can't afford, because that's like almost $5,000 a year.
Yeah, that's a lot of money.
And I was like, I can't afford that. But when, you know, I was worried about my doctor being able to get the prior authorization through. And so I did some research and I found a place called Join Fridays. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of like the med spa place, but they do a compounded, but it's only a little over $200 a month. And that one I can afford a little, you know, easy.
Yeah, but still a lot of money.
It's still a lot of money. So I went ahead and joined and I'm getting my first set of medication soon, and I'm still, and if the prior authorization comes back and I can get it, then I'll cancel the Jordan Fridays, but we'll see. I'm just ready to lose some weight. You know, I was telling my doctor, I was like, if I have to be on medication for the rest of my life, I'd rather be on something that will control my appetite, because that is the thing that has haunted me my entire life. Because mm-hmm. I've done Weight Watchers and I've lost like over 100 pounds. Well, almost 100 pounds. But I gained it all back. Mm-hmm. And I've done keto and I've done Atkins and I've done Weight Watchers. And I do okay with them, but I just always gain it back. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, if I'm going to always gain it back, just give me some medication to help me control this, because mm-hmm. I'm obviously failing at it. And... you know, with the hips, I think the hips exacerbated it because I was forced, not sterility, but sedentary lifestyle. You know, I just couldn't do much.
Right.
And I just haven't recovered from that. And now I don't think I can run anymore because mm-hmm. my hips are still super tight. Mm-hmm. But I've tried really, but but I think once I start losing a little bit of weight, I'll start trying to bicycle a bit. Just because it's less impactful in the hips.
Yep.
So we'll see. Hopefully this time next year, I'll be a skinny little bitch. But
there you go.
Who knows?
And if anything, you can just get one of them little bicycle things that you put underneath your desk. And it just pedal while you're working.
I do want to get... I actually was considering getting one of those folding treadmills. Mm-hmm. You can just walk and do under your desk. So we'll see.
Yep.
I just need to do something more and something different.
Get one of them little bouncy balls. Or those big bouncy balls, yeah. I should say, that you sit on to keeps you, like, makes your
core. Oh, yeah, yeah. Chad, our neighbor Chad, has one, and he said he's already gone through, like, 3 because he's popped them. So, not because he's skinny at the moment.
No,
but
I'm sure he's probably bouncing and, yeah. like, you know.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure the cats
are, like. Because he has ADHD,
too. Oh, yeah. So. So, yeah, we'll see. I'm hoping to have something change soon. Gotcha. Yeah. So we'll see. Hopefully, right. The week other than that, Kalia's been okay. I did get a phone call from teacher that she was being disrespectful, and so I had to.
It's a common theme around here.
Oh God! So Kalia has a delightful habit of having to have the last word in an argument, and she was mad because I guess another kid in class was being rude to her. And teacher didn't hear it, and teacher was telling them to be quiet, and Kalia felt picked on, and so she had to, like, pop off, and was just like, no.
Yeah.
This is not how this works.
And we all know about that pop off.
Yes. Yeah. Zane just got onto her a second ago, because he, he got onto her because, like, he'd asked her 3 times to do something, and she didn't respond to the 3rd time. And started giving him attitude, and he, like, got onto her, and he walked into the other room, and I happened to be next door to where she was getting laundry out of the thing, and I just hear her mumbling in her breath. I was like, babe girl, I suggest you keep that as an inside thought, because that gets you in trouble a lot.
Say it in your head, not out loud. Yes, so I tell Wesley, but he don't listen either, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Crazy, crazy kids.
Crazy, crazy. Trying to think, anything else going on? We had support group a couple of weeks ago. What, it was 2 weeks ago, wasn't it? It was not.
Yes.
This, yeah. That went good.
Yep.
There was a same sex couple in the group. So hopefully we're going to get them on the podcast. And there's a cool couple that I've been wanting to get on. And they said they would be interested. They actually did a news interview about being adoptive parents. So
Cool deal.
And I think Zane's trying to say something. What, baby? Oh, yeah. And we finally got Kalia to watch Goonies last night.
Aw, how'd she like it?
She liked it a lot. She kept, like, making comments about all the cussing. And she's like, he said the S word. I was like, can I spell it? I'm like, yeah. Am I going to get in trouble? No. Am I going to get grounded? No. S-H-I-T. Like, I was like, baby girl, do you want to cuss in front of us? She's like, am I gonna get in trouble? I was like, maybe when you get a little bit older, we'll let you start cussing in front of us. I like when she hits about high school, I suspect I don't mind if she cusses around us a little bit. I definitely don't want her using them as insults or directing them at us. But if she throws a shit out every now and then, I think when she hits high school, I'll be okay with it. Mm-hmm. We'll see.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I'm suspecting Wes is going to start calling you a bitch any day now, Jennifer.
I'm sure he has in his head many, many, many times. But I don't think I would like him cussing around me, because I don't think he would know the difference between, like, insulting and, like, just a...
Yeah, exclamation point.
You know, an expletive. He would use it to hurt not, you know, oh shit, you know, kind of.
Yeah. Oh no. I could definitely see him, like, calling you all the dirty words. And
yeah, I think he can be like me and my mama. I'm a cusser, but I don't cuss around my mama.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah.
I'll keep that. Yeah.
So, but we had a good time. We got to about 30 minutes. We got to where they went down the water slide and landed in the lagoon. Yeah. And it was about 10:15, 10:20, and Clay's like, can we hold off till tomorrow, because I'm tired. I'm like, okay, baby.
Aww.
So we paused it and went to bed.
She's a cutie. I will say, since Jason had altered my dress, and I didn't really trust Wesley zipping me up in my dress.
What?
I'm sure everybody's wondering why I wouldn't, you know, trust him. But I came over here to get into my outfit, and then or into my dress. And I knew that Kalia would love to see me in a dress. So
she
was in the living room, and I was like, Kalia, come here, look. And she gets up, and she just...
It was really cute.
She said, Auntie Jay, you look like a Disney princess. And I was like, aw, I am the Disney villain. I am Ursula when she becomes a human. And then you're like, she's Vanessa. And I was like, that's what her name is. And I couldn't remember her name. But that was, that made me feel like, aw, because you know, she's like, you look like a Disney princess. Aww.
Well, you did look very nice in
it. Well, thank you.
How much was the dress? It's like 20, 30?
55?
Oh, that's not too bad.
I mean, for a bridesmaid dress, I've spent more than that on Sarah's bridesmaid dress when I was her bridesmaid.
Yeah.
Like, we went to, like, David's Bridal.
Yeah.
And, I mean, I spent a good pretty penny for something I ain't ever wore again.
Yeah.
I think I donated it a long time ago.
It is a pretty dress, though.
Yeah, I mean...
If you ever did want to wear it again, we could make you a little bolero, a little like half jacket bolero to cover, because I don't know if you get cold, but.
I did get cold. I really didn't like the half bra. I felt very uncomfortable in that because I couldn't wear a bra with straps because that part, like my shoulders were open. Mm. And so I had to like just wear a half bra. And I didn't like that. It felt very, like, but that was just in the beginning because by the end of the night, I forgot that, you know,
yeah.
I was worried about that because, you know, nothing popped out or, you know, anything like that. So.
You know what we could do? We could, I might throw sleeves on it even.
If yeah, you ever wanted to wear it. I don't think I'm ever going to wear it again, to be honest. I mean.
Okay.
You might, you know, be trying to talk me into it, but I don't think I'm.
Yeah, for all the parties we go to where dresses are required.
That's right. We go to so many parties.
We do. Where dresses are required.
Yes.
Our parties are
more. You would wear the dress at our parties where dresses are required.
If I could even fit it over my chest, I would love to. But you're so tiny compared to I am.
Well, I was just saying like the kind of parties that we go to.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
More so you'd be in a dress than me. So
this is true. This is true. But it is a pretty dress. Can I make a wager? If we get over 50 downloads on this in the next month, can we post a picture of you online on our Instagram?
Okay. I'm sure because of my sisters who love to take pictures and then she had professional pictures done. I'm sure there are going to be lots of pictures of me, at least on the Book of Faces. So
yeah, but all those profiles are private.
I know, but I mean, what's another thing I'm not looking at?
Okay. All right. So to our 15 listeners, if you want to see Jennifer in a dress, download and tell your friends to download and we'll post a picture on the podcast Instagram of her in a dress looking all sorts of beautiful.
Aww. Aww. Well, I appreciate that part, but the y'all just listen. You don't got to download. Just listen to it and then you're good.
It'll show up in the statistics. It'll show up.
You don't have to do anything else, guys. Nothing else. We're good. I'm just being silly.
All right, Ms. Jennifer, what are we drinking today?
We are drinking, Cooper and Thief, but not the one we usually drink. Mm-hmm. This is one that Zane got down in Auburn. It is a Pinot Noir.
I think it is. I'm not sure. It is aged in a barrel, a liquor barrel of some sort, but I don't think it's wrong. I don't know. Zane, you want to go look? I don't know. Zane called me. He went to the A-Day game at Auburn with Kalia and his mom. And he's like, oh, I'm at World Market. Do you want me to pick up a bottle? I was like, yeah, pick up a couple bottles for the podcast. And so he picked up this. This is one of them. So it's Pinot Noir. Is it aged anything? Can you tell? Let's see. It says it is. Can I read that? Aged in a brandy barrel.
Oh, okay.
Come on, brandy.
That's cool.
She's a fine girl.
She's Are you just going to kill the rest of it, babe?
Oh, yeah.
You ain't going to share with us?
You had your chance.
Oh.
No, we didn't. We're recording.
Yeah.
See what we had to put up with, people. Yeah. So, yeah, I like it. I think it's a little sweeter than, or I don't know, is it sweet?
I don't think it. Sweet.
It says lush and jammy with salted caramels.
That's what the bottle any says. Of that. But
I can the jam. I can kind of pick up a little
jam?
Bit.
Jam.
Well, because it's a light, has kind of a.
But you said it.
It has a little bit of a fruit flavor to it.
Uh huh.
And it. I apologize to our listeners with that smacking sound. I try and edit them out, but every now and then one escapes my gay mouth. Yeah, I don't know. Which do you prefer, the regular Pinot or Cooper Thief or this one?
I think I prefer the regular one.
The other one has like a slight tobacco flavor, I think. This one is just is fruitier.
Yeah.
But they're both great.
They are. I mean, I'm not saying this one's not, you know, not good in that I would not drink this one again, but
yeah,
I think I'm still partial to the original one for us.
Yeah. All right, Miss Jennifer. So we've got our cocktail. Let's talk about season three and how it went.
Season three.
I was proud. I will say the thing that I'm proudest of us about season three is the first two seasons, if I remember correctly, we only did 12 to 13 episodes those two seasons. Mm-hmm. And then this one we did 26. Mm. So, you know, we really put out a lot of episodes this season. So I'm proud of us for that.
I'm proud of it. Proud of us for that as well.
Yeah. And we never missed a week.
Yeah. We did really well, especially with me having foot surgery. And,
And maybe being a lazy fucker.
We did technically miss 1 week, didn't we? That Zane had to.
Zane had to co.
That was because of the babies, right?
Yeah, Zane had to take over for you a couple times, but we, you know, something got produced every week.
Yeah.
So, I'm, you know, I'll admit I've been a day late a couple episodes. Ooh. But I think is season four. I'm actually going to put our release date back to Wednesday.
Okay.
So it gives me a little time to edit. Because I'll. Because
sometimes we do it on Sunday evening.
Yeah, and I get busy Monday during the day.
What? You work?
I work, and I have a child.
What?
That I have to, a 10-year-old that irritates the shit out of me.
And takes a lot of your time.
Yes. So, I think that was, I'm really proud of that. And the thing I'm really excited about with season four is all the people that have already said they want to come be on the podcast.
Yeah, that we don't have to fight to find people, that we actually have people like asking us. That's wicked cool.
I know. We already have three published authors asking to be on the podcast. So we're going to start hopefully doing some video content.
You want to.
I do. My plan is to do some TikToks. Jennifer and I have a cocktail every episode, so I want to try and do a little cocktail review on TikTok and Instagram reels and YouTube shorts, so we can get our viewership up or listenership up, I guess.
Yeah, it just means I get to drink some more, so I'm okay. That's right.
Well, unfortunately, it means we're also going to have to go through that god awful Costco wine advent calendar and be like, "Ugh, what crap did we get this time?"
Well, that's why we got another one for. That's why you got another one for Christmas, just for you to be able to do this.
This is true.
It wasn't our decision.
I will say to our 15 listeners, if you have any recommendations of snacks you have for us or booze, say Jennifer doesn't like beer, so can't do beer.
No beer.
Ciders, Jennifer schools with, but they have to be kind of sweet, if I remember correctly, right?
No.
No?
Not necessarily.
Okay.
My favorite one wasn't sweet. It just was a really high alcohol content, and I loved it, but I can't find it no more, so okay. I'm sad.
So, yeah, for our 15 listeners, if you have any recommendations of booze or snacks, please send them in. We'd love to hear them. And I was telling Jennifer, on Mondays when I do Kalia has art class, and I'll drop her off, and then I'll go hang out the open bottle in Madison and just have a beer. And I was like, I need to ask, like, our local, like, the Nook or the Open Bottle or Liquor Express, if they'll sponsor, you know, the podcast, and we'll give them some advertising for
some alcohol.
Yeah, a bottle of wine or something like that. Yeah. Hopefully, I'll go ask.
I mean, I told you, you were talking like we should go do that. I'm like, yeah, that's something that you can do.
Well,
I was like, I don't want to do that.
Well, I was talking, Zane and I were talking about the Open Bottle, and they actually have a performance space, a stage in their back area. I was like, that would be really cool if we could do a Guide to Poor Parenting live there, show. The only problem is you have to provide your own like AV equipment.
Oh.
And I don't have anything fancy, so I don't know that we could do something live.
Yeah.
So
we might need to go to
Shenanigans.
Yeah.
Yeah, because they could just record it for us.
Right.
But
that's what I was thinking.
Yeah. I'm hoping by the end of season four, if our listenership is up enough, I'll talk to Kim and Jessica about it, about doing a live, and maybe we can do like one every year or so.
That'd be cool.
We'll see. I think we're going to have...
Maybe one day, if we ever get like paid, we could travel. Because we have people that listen to us overseas.
Yes.
And I would love to go traveling overseas.
Hell yeah. I would
get
love to.
Get paid to like talk and drink shit. Yeah.
Fuck yeah. I mean, like one weekend in a month, we could probably knock out like 6 interviews and have like a month's worth of content. So I'd be happy and finally start. Oh, I did. Did I tell you about the, I don't know if we mentioned on the podcast, but so we use our podcasting service is called Blueberry.
Oh, is it?
And they have a dashboard that gives you listener statistics on where your listeners come from. Uh-huh. And, you know, most of it's obviously in the United States, and most of it concentrated here in Alabama. The second highest, I think, is Tennessee. So thank you, Benjamin. Appreciate it. The rest of the, you know, a big chunk is in Texas, which doesn't surprise me because I have so many friends out there. But there was, you know, we've got about 1,000 downloads total of our podcast, and we have about 60 from Canada.
Okay.
And 57 of them are from Manitoba. Which is like, there ain't nothing in Manitoba. I was like, what is the biggest city in Manitoba? And Saskatchewan, I think.
Okay.
And there, I was like, that's a that's smaller than Huntsville.
Well, I mean, we could travel to Canada.
Hell yeah.
To Manitoba.
During the summer.
And get those, and get those 50.
Those 56 listeners
come visit us. Buy some merch.
There you go.
Eventually we'll have merch, maybe.
Well,
you've been talking about it.
I've been talking about it. And there, since we got a new logo, which we'll be introducing in May, I'm going to put out some merch for us. So hopefully I'm going to, if I can actually, I don't necessarily profit, but if I can get a little income generated from this podcast, so it's not just me pouring money or shoveling money into a fire, a fun alcoholic fire, but it's still a fire. I will probably pay someone to come up with a better website and like some merch, maybe start selling it, Shenanigans, shit like that.
Yep. Or online.
So, online, yeah. That's probably online first, just because I don't think you have, with online, I think you can do the, like you can say, print me this shirt with this logo, and we just get the proceeds. We don't have to like buy anything. They just print it on the fly. So we'll see. So hopefully, so merch, video content, you'll get to see our beautiful faces.
Sure.
Jennifer will not be looking at.
Nope.
What else? What else are we hoping for this coming season? More interviews.
Yeah.
We're going to hopefully get Zane's.
Cooler people. Yeah. And, well,
cool people.
You're about to say his family, so yeah, we've already met them. But like the authors sound really cool.
Yeah, and then
interview people from out.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Two of the authors will be remote. Oh, and hopefully we're gonna get our friend Feige on. He's got some horror stories.
Oh my goodness.
So
if we can get him on and he likes it, we will have him every season because he has so many stories that I don't know if people want to continue listening to something. They'll be like, I had never ever having no kids after hearing that one.
I'm excited. He had another story.
You can't tell his stories. He's going to tell his stories.
Well, I'll tell you afterwards. But it basically entails one of his children went to go live with girlfriend's family, and they were charging him a certain amount of money for rent.
Okay.
And then he stopped paying, and so they called Feige and Roy. We're like, hey, pay us his rent.
No.
Yeah, and he's 19, and Feige and Roy are like, nope.
Nope.
Well, he
that Feige would have been was. a big fat
Feige is saying fuck that, and but I was like, do you think Roy's gonna honor that? He's like, probably not.
Sorry, you made a deal with someone that is old enough.
Sucks to be y'all.
Definitely. That's funny.
All right, so let's think about, if I were a better editor, I would have come up with a clip package so we could do a clip review of our season. But I'm looking back at the actual podcast so we can see what episodes. Do you have any episodes that stick out to you or any people we interviewed? I know
Tim.
Yeah,
I really liked the flow with Tim.
Yeah. Tim is a radio personality, so he knows how to talk.
He knows how to talk.
He knows how to tell a story.
Yep. And I mean, just like the vibe was there. And then we went on his podcast, which I don't know if it will ever come out. Not sure yet, but I really liked him. Another one that pops out of my mind, I don't remember who it was, but the Demon Baby.
That was Leanne.
Yep.
Funniest woman in Huntsville.
Yeah. Demon Baby, really? I don't think I'll ever forget that, no matter how bad my memory is. Because that was, yeah, demon baby. That's definitely one that, you know, that sticks out.
I the demon baby was funny, but the her growing up in a, like not a, even a cult, but it was, yeah, it was like
a bunker.
Yeah, bunker, yeah. Basically.
Well, I mean, that's underground.
Yeah,
that's what I think of, is that it was a bunker
and they're still living in it. Well, the uncle brother, or, the yeah, uncle, yeah,
yeah, her uncle, sorry. Yeah, yeah, those definitely are two that will, Tim and demon baby will probably stick with me for a while.
Yeah, I was telling Jennifer, so to pull the veil back for our listeners, we record a lot of our interviews like early on in the season. So we'll have like almost all our interviews like banked well before we release them. And mm-hmm. So the night before I will release the podcast or that episode, I have to like, you know, I'll put a little summary in there and try and think of three things we talked about. Mm-hmm. Tim and Elise were so far back, I had to like listen to it again because I forgot. I'm going to have to get a piece of paper. I'm like, okay, what the fuck did we talk about? Because I don't remember shit.
Well, you said you were going to do that.
Yeah. Or at least take notes or something. Yeah. Because, you know, the outlines help a lot, especially since I have to tell what we're drinking and eating. But
yeah,
half the time I'm just like, what the fuck did we talk
about?
Well,
and you want to take notes so that you can put the description.
Yeah.
On.
And that.
But if we do it Wednesdays, it gives you a little bit of time. You could listen back on the podcast too, not try to do it that morning of, or, you know.
I'm hoping yeah, you're totally right. What I'm hoping is that I will be able to like put out some of the social media stuff on Monday. Mm-hmm. You know, like the pictures from the food and whatnot.
I try. I haven't.
No, been you're doing great.
I have not been doing very well lately, just because of the foot and work.
Oh,
I
haven't. Fine.
I don't think I put anything on Instagram in a couple of weeks, but I will. I will do that today.
And then, you know, I'm going to start trying to get clips cut out from the audio so I can post them on Reels and TikTok and Facebook and all that shit.
Yep.
And then Wednesday we'll do the release. So
that works.
Yeah.
So give you some more time because, you know, like you said, you work.
Yeah,
you
know, baby. I for all our loyal listeners, I appreciate y'all sticking through us with this and me, because I'm like doing my best, but there's a competition of A, my responsibilities, and B, my laziness, and C, my like desire to do this podcast. They fight sometimes.
Yeah, but that makes sense because, you know, it's an active podcast.
This is true.
You know, what were some of your like, ones that you asked me first, and I was nice to go, especially as bad a memory as I have. You've been able to look at stuff, so.
I would say comedian Melissa was one of my favorite stories. She is just a pistol.
Yep.
She came to our Christmas party afterwards, and she's hooting a holler. I cannot imagine taking Clea to a strip club in the park, sitting in the parking lot and watching strange men going strip club.
Yeah.
So funny.
That was a funny one.
And I was so excited to get people from our support group, Melissa and Aaron.
Yep.
It was so great to have them on. They're definitely such sweet people.
They are.
They're
so nice.
They are. And, you know, every time we bitch about our kids, I just think about Melissa specifically with her six adoptive kids and all the hell she's gone through. And
yeah.
So I'm like, okay, we don't have it so bad.
Well,
I mean, we shouldn't be comparing her pain, but it's still like, you know, she also has a husband to help too.
Right.
So,
and she did that on purpose.
This is true.
She, you know.
And your adoption was by accident?
No. The six part.
Oh, well, yeah.
Was on purpose.
Yeah, that's true.
The one part on mine was, yes, on purpose. But, yeah. I just don't. And it's so funny because when we're in the support group, they either have one or they have 25. I'm exaggerating, of course, but that's what it feels like. You don't have like a one or a two. It's either one or it's 5 to 10.
Yeah.
And then there's fosters and adopted and biological, and they just merge all of them together. And I mean, I think even if I had someone to help, no. And, you know, some of them have six and they are single moms. And you think, how in the world do you do this? It is, I have so much help from you, Jason and Zane, that what if they don't have that, you know, the tribe that yeah. helps? It's just the craziest thing to me.
I don't know how. I won't mention her name because it's...
Yeah,
know,
well, that's why I didn't say nobody's
yeah,
name.
All hats off to this lady that does it, because I'm just so impressed with her.
Definitely.
I can't imagine.
I'm in awe of her every time that, you know, we talk.
Because she's a tiny little thing, too.
Yes.
And like,
but she does only do girls.
This is true.
Well, sometimes she'll get a boy every once in a while, but I mean, I think she tries to stick with just girls.
Yeah.
But I mean, girls are sometimes worse than boys.
So. Well, she's also like tinier than her older two girls. Like she's so itty bitty. Yeah. If she's over 5 foot tall, 5 foot two, I'd be amazed.
Yeah.
And her daughters, I think, are already 5'5", 5'6", her older ones. So I'm just like.
But yeah, hats off.
Yeah, hats off to her.
If she listens, you know who you are.
I doubt she listens because she's too fucking busy with five
kids.
Well,
that is very true, but I just said if.
Yeah.
You know?
I will say we did have one sad moment this podcast, this season.
Yeah.
So back in, when did we release that one? That was back in March. December. No, shit, I don't remember when it was released. It was in between Christmas and New Year's.
Yeah.
We had Ashton and Emily come on, and we lost Ashton right after the New Year's.
Yep.
I don't want to get too much specifics on how we lost him, but he left behind a very young wife and a very young baby, and everybody, he was like well loved at Shenanigans, and it was incredibly sad.
Yep.
So
and surprising to me, because when we talked, you never really know what's going on inside
someone's head.
Brain and their emotions. But he seemed like he was happy.
Well,
he came to the Christmas party. Yeah. He just, you know, I did not see any signs. Now, mind you, I'm just a person that met him on a podcast to talk to him and then saw him at a Christmas party. So I didn't see him every day today, you know.
Yeah.
But it's just...
Shocking.
It's shocking that, you know, someone that you just talked to and this is what happened. It's just a crazy thing. You never know what's going on with somebody.
Yeah. It broke my heart too. And it was weird because I definitely was friendly with him, but I don't, you know, I'd only hung out three times, including the two, once at Shenanigans, once at the podcast and once at the party.
Yeah.
So I definitely would say we're friendly and maybe becoming friends, but we were not close friends by any stretch of the imagination. And he had called me just a few days before his passing, asking for help. And then his wife was like, "Hey, can I have his copy of the audio because we lost him?" And I was just like, I couldn't.
Yeah.
Oh, it broke my heart.
That was just,
So
RIP.
All right. Rest in power. Rest in perfection.
Oh. Yeah, I was going to rest in power.
I don't know how powerful it was, but rest in perfection, my dear. We miss you.
Yeah, I would have loved to have been his friend, like, you know, to keep having him come on and come over for, like, parties and stuff and with his wife, because she was really sweet.
Yeah, she was really sweet.
I would have loved to have met their child.
Their baby.
Their baby.
Oh, so sad.
Maybe when the baby's a little older, but you know.
Oh, so Emily, if you're listening, I don't know if you are because you're so busy, but our heart goes out to you. And if you would like to come on the podcast for season 4-5, maybe come, just let us know.
Yep.
All right. So, yeah, I think those were my big ones for this season.
Yeah.
None of the solo ones, really. Frankly, the solo ones are us just being whiny bitches.
Because we talk so much outside of the podcast and then on the podcast, I can't tell you what we've talked about, to be honest.
It's like nothing new, no new information when we're doing solo.
Not really. I mean, it is to the listeners, but to us, it's, you know, we've already talked multiple times either through the week or on the weekend. So yeah, none of those are, but the guests are always, you know, nice because it's more on them than it is on us.
Agreed.
And I like to hear other people's stories and how they grew up and how they have demon babies.
Agreed.
But, you know, so I'm looking forward to our guests.
Yeah,
and I am too. Season four.
I am too.
Especially like when we can get to Feige, because mm-hmm. I think he's definitely a good storyteller yeah. and has plenty of stories. And then the authors sound really cool.
Yeah.
You know, to get to talk to them. I'm excited about that.
Yeah.
Because I know that's too. The next part of your little bit is to talk about what we're excited yeah, about yeah. season four. So I just started it off before yeah. you could ask.
Hey, you're the co-host too, girl. I think the things I'm excited about for season four are, I know you're not crazy about, but the video elements, just because, yeah. you know, like, it seems like nowadays podcasts are going all video.
Yeah.
And I want to, you know, I finally published the podcast to YouTube, and we're actually getting decent views, like yeah. nothing crazy, but we're also, you know, just releasing. So, yeah. I think the episode about resentment, we already got 22 views on it within oh, wow. a day. So, and it Dang. Took us, you know, it took us 3 years to get up to 100 listens a month. So, yeah. you know, the YouTube algorithm really helps everything.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping it helps. And, I was going to say, what were we just talking about before? Oh, man, it just flew up my damn mind. And that's what the format for season four. So I,
that's
you know,
not what we were talking about.
But well, I, that was a thought that was in my mind that I needed to talk to you about.
Okay.
So for season three, we've been doing two solos per every one interview. Mm-hmm. Jennifer and I have been talking about whether we should keep that or we should go back to a one-to-one, just because we have so many interview requests mm-hmm. already. I don't know, for our 15 listeners, Benjamin, Mike, what do y'all think? email us at guidetopoorparenting@gmail.com. We'd love to hear. If y'all like hearing us bitch about our kids.
Like and, two times?
Yeah.
Double time, then
yeah.
just tell us. If you don't, you'd prefer to have one and then an interview, let us know.
Yeah. I mean, I do think we will eventually probably get to the point where we're kind of struggling. We're already starting to struggle on ideas to talk about.
The topics, yeah.
Yeah. So I think by necessities, we will have to go back to one-to-one.
Or we could do one topic one time, and then the next time it's me and you, we just talk about our week, because sometimes we tend to go into more of that than we do the actual topic.
Yeah.
Because a lot happens
yeah.
in 7 days.
It's true.
I will say, when we get into the video format, because I don't like light, I'm a vampire. If you see me in shades, it is not because I'm trying to look cool. It is just so that I don't
get a headache.
Have my brain explode. Yeah.
Jennifer and I usually record this like in the afternoon on a Sunday, and we have the curtains drawn, and I have to turn on my lamp over me so I can see what the fuck I'm doing. But I know Jennifer's like, oh, I just don't want to turn that light off, please.
And I'm just in the my area is kind of dark.
Yeah.
So I'm good.
But if we do video, we'll have to get like a ring light on.
Yeah, and that's gonna be bright as fuck. So
we'll get you some of those welding glasses so you can see shit.
Well, I have to be able to see like my food and my drink.
And the
so,
outline,
you know.
Yeah. That's true.
And the outline, definitely. So just wanted to say, it's not because I'm trying to look cool, but so. I am. Not really. But, you know, yeah. that's yeah. why shades would be on.
But yeah, like I said, for our 15 listeners, please let us know. Like, and I'm not joking when I say Benjamin and Mike, please email yeah. us. Let us know what you think. You know, when we started this, it was just kind of a cathartic thing where like we need to whine and bitch. We're already whining and bitching about our kids.
Yeah.
What do y'all think?
Right. And trying to help other people, maybe help other people, I should say, and or just letting other people know that
they're not alone.
They're not alone. Benjamin told me the podcast helps him with his decision not to have kids. So
smart
we
man.
Might help people, you know, in that way as well.
Yeah.
Because Benjamin is just like, yeah, I'm good. Yeah. I don't want that.
Well, as our friend EJ, who comes over every Sunday for dinner, I think being around our kids has definitely convinced him that he doesn't want yeah. kids.
It is definitely birth control.
Yeah.
Because you don't know what you're getting into or how things change. Because 8-year-old Wesley is way, 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 way. I don't know how many ways I can put there. Different than 13-year-old Wesley.
Yeah. He never fought.
It's night and fucking day.
Yeah.
It is crazy what the fuck. Hormones and middle school and oh my God. And I've always been told that middle school is probably the hardest part of parenting.
Yeah. And he's old for a seventh grader, sixth grader.
Sixth grader. Yes. Because he went to kindergarten as a 6-year-old because his birthday is in February. So they didn't let him go as 5. So he went as 6. So when he was in kindergarten by the end of it at 7.
Yeah.
So he's going to be an old high schooler. And that scares me because
he's already talking about dropping out.
Well, not even that. It's the laws of Alabama.
Oh yeah.
And his mental age is going to be 15 when he's a 19-year-old, and he'll be dating a 16-year-old, and that could be statutory rape.
It's true.
And if he dates a little white girl and he's black and daddy don't like it because we're in Alabama, he could be on the child sex offender registry.
I think the bigger issue you'll have is if you ever get him a cell phone, he'll be sending in dick pics.
Well, I mean, I also
getting them too.
I mean, at this point in what I'm thinking because of all the stuff that Melissa told me about, because anything he sends would be on me if I get him one.
Yeah. He'll have to just get it himself.
So I'm not going to get him a cell phone, a plan. He'll have to do all of that either by minutes or getting his own plan because I am not going to be responsible for what he does.
Yeah. Especially with a kid like that.
Right.
Yeah. I agree.
I can't even give him a stupid phone because the stupid phone even has a camera on it. So I'm fucked either way. So I just think I'm...
Yeah. No, I agree.
And you just do your own shit.
Kalia's been asking about cell phones too because she's 10 and I guess a lot of kids are having them at this age.
They have them at 5.
Which kills me.
Yes.
It's like, I try to limit her smaller screen. Like TV, we don't restrict as much as we probably should. But it's like Zane and I kind of were raised by the TV too. So it's like, I don't have as much problem with it.
But we didn't have
the streaming on-demand stuff. Yeah.
And we had whatever the fuck was on. And we knew there was no cussing until after a certain time at night. When that's when the adult TV came on. Yeah. And you have 4 channels, 5 channels to choose from. Depending on what era you lived in.
And how rich
you were.
In
Germany, you only had one English channel. But they have so much access now.
Yeah.
It's hard. That is just, it's scary.
Yeah. I will say, even with all the access she has, she's still pretty, innocent. Maybe not innocent, but, she at least comes off that way of, shocked. They cussed. I'm like, okay. You're fine then.
Yeah, but then sometimes you'll hear her in her YouTube shorts or whatever.
Oh, yeah,
TikToks,
yeah.
And then you hear them cussing and she doesn't say shit. So.
Yeah. So I don't
think it's because grandpa was there kind of thing.
I also think it's just Kalia too. Yeah. She you yell at her and she's like, I got in trouble. I'm like, did I punish you?
Yeah.
But I got yelled at. I'm like, did I punish you?
Did you get grounded till the end of the school year?
Yeah. So she's just a sensitive little soul.
Yes, she is. And I love her dearly.
She is a sweet pea.
And I would trade you anytime.
So, for our 15 listeners, let us know what you think. What would you like to hear?
Yep.
We're always, we're open. Mike, we super appreciate that email you sent us this season.
Definitely.
Giving us some ideas.
You could just text me. You don't have to email.
And if you watch us on YouTube, comment. We'd love to hear your comments.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I know that there's some podcasts that don't let you rate it or put anything on it. Because I know we say if you give us 5 stars or whatever, but some of them don't let you do that.
Well, I know with Spotify, you have to subscribe and listen to a few before you can rate it. And I actually went into it. I was like, I'm going to just say I listened to it. And then it let me rate.
Bring our numbers up, Jason.
Hey, whatever I got to do, baby. I'll buy some subscribers just to look better. So yeah, so we're not done yet, but we'll be listening. We'll be back on May 15th. Hopefully, I'll do better than last season when I put out that little minute-long episode apologizing for being late. But right now, the goal is May 15th.
Yeah, I want to say that Amazon doesn't let you
rate. Yeah, I think you're right on Amazon.
And I know there's at least one. I think it's Amazon Music that doesn't let you rate them.
Yeah.
So, but I mean, you know.
On iTunes and Spotify and YouTube Music, I think you can. So
yeah,
we appreciate anything.
Awesome.
Yeah. Right. So it was a good transition spot. So if you have any funny stories about your kids,
or if you need some bad parenting advice,
email us at guidetopoorparenting@gmail.com.
Yep.
Miss Jennifer, you want to ask me?
Yes. Jason, what are we snacking on today?
Well, Zane and I went and had brunch this morning at, what is it called?
West End Grill.
West End Grill here in Huntsville. Delightful place for brunch.
I know. With Papa.
With Papa, Zane's dad.
Freddie.
Hopefully he'll be on the podcast this coming season.
No, that'd be good.
Poor thing forgot his hearing aid, though, so we kept trying to say what? What?
Oh, well, he'll definitely have to have it for the podcast.
Yeah.
I'd love to hear, you know, his side of Zane. We already got Sandra. I'd love to hear Freddie's side.
I've gotten a few good stories about him.
I like Freddie. I've met him many times, but to have him sit down and talk about Zane, this is going to be fun. Because I know Zane's probably thinking, you can also ask about, Shayna, but no.
So anyway, after brunch, Jose and I went grocery shopping at Walmart, and I was checking out, and they had these little, I was trying to think what we were going to have for snacks, and I just looked.
I had a ton from New Market.
And Zane was really sweet and bought some snacks for New Market.
But we thought they were for him.
No, I knew they were for us.
Oh, you didn't tell me that part.
Oh, sorry. Well, anyway, it was the end of the season, and I was like, I know Jennifer likes Nutella.
Okay, Jennifer loves Nutella. Yes.
And so
get it right.
I was in line to check out, and they had these little Nutella snacks, which are, it's like a, do you remember the dipsticks from when we were for any?
Well, it's also like the cheese and crackers.
Yeah. So like one half is Nutella, the other half is breadsticks, basically, like you get. And you just dip, and they're delightful and wonderful. And I was like, you know what? I wanted something sweet, and I knew Jennifer would like it. So yes. I was like, you know what? We're going to do this. We'll save Zane's snacks for season 4.
There you go.
And don't ever think I don't appreciate you, Zane, because I do. I just saw it, and it was a spur of the moment thing. So
he just thought of me and Nutella.
Yeah, and I wanted something sweet too.
There you go.
So we are having Nutella with breadsticks from Walmart, and they're delightful.
Well, I mean, you can get them anywhere.
All right. So instead of, to kick off the season or to finish out the season, we'll do like we did last finale. We're going to read some Reddit stories. Although we are already at 55 minutes.
Oh.
Although if you're listening, it'll probably be closer to 50, but we'll maybe just do one story each. So I curated, I'm on Reddit, and I have I joined the parenting and adoption subreddits, and I've been saving some posts from those subreddits, and so I texted Jennifer a couple of them, stories.
I got mine.
You got yours?
Yep.
Okay, you want to go first, and I'll find mine?
I mean, if you want to.
Yeah, you better do it, because I got to find mine again.
I like this one just because it reminds me of what I've told Wesley. So the title is, Am I Entitled to a Key to My Daughter's Bedroom? First off, on my son's door, the lock is on the outside. Not that I can lock him in, but that he can't lock me out. Because my house is my house.
Yeah.
I pay for it. You stay in a room that I provide. It is not your room. You have no right to privacy in my house. This is how I feel. Especially with as much shit as he has stole and taken over the years, he has not earned the right to any privacy. So, in my opinion, yes, you're entitled if this is your fucking house. Yeah. But anyways, so the story is, my 19-year-old, which is way different than a 13-year-old.
Yeah, that makes it a little bit weirder. But
it does make it a little weirder. But my 19-year-old daughter wants to get a lock on her bedroom door to keep her sister out. We said fine, as long as we have a key. We don't normally go in there, but God forbid for emergencies. She says she doesn't have to give us one. Thoughts? Well, get your own fucking house. You're 19. I mean, you can't. No.
Yeah, I agree.
Well, either give them a key because it's their fucking house, or move the fuck out if you don't want your sister in your room.
I mean, yeah, I kind of agree. It's, well, even if she moves out and got her own apartment, the landlord's going to have a key.
Right.
So, you know,
some creepy motherfucker's gonna might have the key and might come in your house and be like,
sweaty, hairy Iranian man.
I had to fix the sink or whatever. Mm-hmm. You never know.
Unless you own the house, you do not have exclusive rights to your own keys.
That's right.
So, yeah, I mean, like, even if she's 19, I agreed, she deserves her own privacy, especially at 19. Like, she definitely doesn't deserve to have her sister going through her shit. But if you're the homeowner, I get a, like, when we let Justin put a key lock on his, but I was like, you have to let us have the key.
Yeah.
Because we need to be able to get in there for, but I'll respect your privacy and I'll knock. And but if
he earned it.
Yeah.
Yes. But I mean, you're 19 years old. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I agreed. No, I agree. I mean, even like if even now Kalia's 10, I try to respect her privacy as much. I knock before I enter. I try to anyway. Sometimes I don't always do.
Well, good. You're a lot nicer than I am.
Oh, yeah. But I also don't have, like, Kalia doesn't steal like Wesley does too.
I mean, yeah.
And he doesn't.
She's not Wesley. We'll just say that.
She's, yeah. I sleep later than she does. Yeah. And like, she's always up earlier than I am. And so, like, if I have to go in there, it's usually like, okay, I'm going to knock first, especially as she's gotten older. A lot of it too is like, she's gotten more self-conscious, but just like, you know, I'm a 46 year old man.
You don't want to walk in if she's half naked. Yeah. And,
yeah. That's kind of inappropriate because she's a full figured girl.
She is. Yeah.
So, yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, that was like because Wesley's like, that's my room. No, motherfucker. Mm-mm. It's my room. I let you stay there. I could just put a mattress on the floor. It's all you fucking need.
I mean, yeah. I mean, if he was like a better kid, if it could be a different discussion.
It would be, but he's not.
And if he were older, it might be a different discussion too. But even still, it's like, it's still your house and you have a right to enter any room you want.
That, yeah.
So I'm like,
I am old school in that aspect because, I mean, I don't remember me ever fighting with my mom about like privacy or whatever, because she was a German woman. So, I mean, she would rock around topless because that's how they do.
Yeah.
And her seeing me as a woman to a girl at the time, there's no like weirdness in that.
Yeah.
I don't think I ever had like, this is my room, don't come into my room. What I had was, I didn't clean my room the way it should be cleaned.
What?
When I was a teenager. You know, and it's not like it was food like Wesley. Just clothes strewn everywhere. Because I didn't believe in putting clothes in a hamper, apparently. Yeah. And so my friends would come over and she'd be like, yeah, just go on in. And I have drawers and, you know, just everything just strewn about. Y'all, that taught me. My room stays clean.
Yeah.
Like, I put all my clothes in my hamper. If anyone, like, nowadays, it's, what if the fire department has to come in or the police because I've, you know, done died or whatever.
Yeah.
There's no clothes that are going to be like, oh, don't look at that, like the unmentionables.
Yeah.
I have agreed. Hamper.
Yeah. Well, you know, like, I was thinking about this too. Even if I were renting out my room to a stranger, I'd be like, I still need to have a key. I was like, I will respect your privacy. I won't go in there.
Yeah.
But I still need to have a key in case I like something happens and I have to get in there because I don't have to drill it out.
Right.
So yeah, you like,
even there's still ways of getting in.
Yeah. I was like, even if we put a key on there, I could still drill it out if I had to.
Right.
So yeah, in your house, you have to have that access.
Yeah.
Just for safety, frankly.
Yep.
So yeah, I agree. So I think we're on the same page. Okay. All right. So my story is, my Reddit post was, is Disney World worth it? Question mark. I have a 9 and 10 year old.
Nope.
I have a 9 and 10 year old daughters who have friends who have gone to Disney World and they've been begging us for years. I am not a Disney person. My husband is even less of a Disney person than me. We went to Universal and I liked it, but it was still a lot of work and very busy days. We are the type of people who like to explore different cities and or not always be on a schedule. I know Disney will be a lot of work, very scheduled and much busier. And not only that, but it is so expensive. With that said, I know my kids are only a little are only little once, and I want to savor every moment of it. For those of you who are reluctant to go and went, did you think it was worth it? I am currently 50-50. I'm currently 50-50 on going. I have no idea if my husband will want to do it at all. And if not, I have to ask my mom and sister, who I know will say yes. Thanks.
I never got to go to Disney as a child. I took my child to Disney. Well, I mean, we all went together.
Yeah.
You and me, but I took my child. I had a fucking blast. He would rather go fucking swimming. So I say leave their ass. Don't let them go. Let them do the decision when they get older and they can pay for it. Whoops.
At 9 and 10, I don't know. I agree.
When we took, because Kalia was 9, right?
Or 8.
And then yeah. Wesley was 11.
The thing, so A, you have to make your money's worth it. You have to walk a shit ton. And it is exhausting.
Yeah.
And these are, you know, Jennifer was like late 30s. I was mid 40s. And so I was exhausted the entire time. And the kids were worn out too.
Yeah.
So I would say if you're going to do it, wait till you are, they are old enough to go out on their own away from you.
Yeah.
If you really want to go, go when they're like 13, 14. So you are comfortable with them walking around and they can get back to the hotel on their own or something. At that age, they won't enjoy it. Well, they will enjoy it probably, yeah. But it won't be worth it because it is so goddamn expensive. And unless you're staying on property and spending like 3 days at Magic Kingdom,
yeah,
and there's no one in the park with you, it sucks.
Yeah.
Because if you have to park, which we did, which wasn't terrible, but it was still an ordeal and getting the kids up, and they were exhausted.
The weather didn't sit right for us when we're, you know, many, many miles away from home.
Mm-hmm.
Couldn't find a hoodie that I could afford.
Yeah.
Save my life that first day.
And it was, we went in February when we thought it was going to be dead and it was packed.
Yeah.
So.
Cheerleader competition.
Yeah, cheerleader.
Did she say that they went to Universal?
Yes.
And they didn't like Universal.
No, I think they said that. Hold on, let me look at it again. They did like it.
They said it was a lot of work.
We went to Universal and I liked it, but it was still a lot of work and very busy days.
Disney is even more work because Universal, everything was more close together.
Yeah.
I liked Universal more than I liked Disney.
Agreed.
As an adult and just for your ability to ride more rides or see more attractions and stuff.
Yeah, agreed.
I mean, I still love Disney. Don't get me wrong. Animal Kingdom was my favorite because there's rides and animals. Like, two things Jennifer loves.
I liked Animal Kingdom, but it was so fucking spread out.
But it was, I mean, I don't care about it.
It was really cool, but I was so tired.
Yeah, but I mean, I think that's what they want you to be. Yeah. If you had trouble with Universal, you're going to have even more trouble with Disney. Yeah. That's where I was going with that. It's because everything was more close together at Universal.
Yeah, I agree. If you're not a Disney person, wait till go when you guarantee it's not going to be busy. So like I plan it better. I thought I had planned it well, but I did not realize there was going to be a fucking cheerleading competition that weekend.
Or so, just don't go and let your kids go when they get older, like I did.
Or drop them off.
Well,
get them to the age when you can be like, all right, you go do your shit. I'm going to go do mine.
Yeah, but teenagers don't want to do that.
I think Kalia, they're both daughters, though, and I think they would.
Maybe.
So
I guess it just depends on how close the daughters are. Well, like if they would want to ride together and I meant not like age, emotionally. But like, you know, not even emotional, like if they like each other.
Well,
because some siblings don't like each other. Zane and Shayna.
Well, yeah. You know, me and my brother.
They would probably kill each other if you dropped them off at Disney.
No, I mean, if they're both like, let's say the youngest one is 13, the older one is 14, and they could just go do their own shit. It'd be like, here's some money for food. Go have fun.
Well, I guess if they don't have to be together.
Yeah, if they don't have to be together, I'd say, fuck it, go have fun. Yeah. I don't know. I will say cruises and amusement parks are a whole lot more fun with your friends than they are with your children. Or with your aging parents. Because I did that with my...
Well, then why the fuck am I taking my first cruise with my son?
Because you can drop him off.
Oh, okay.
I can't drop my mother. Well, I could probably... No. I had to
share... Drop her off at the casino.
Well, no. It wasn't my parents that was the problem. It was that I had to share a room with my brother. And I couldn't just like hang out there if I just needed to take a nap.
Yeah.
Because he would take it over and not bathe and stink.
Yeah.
up the room.
So you're talking about yourself as like a younger Jason.
Everything's more fun with your friends.
Oh yeah. Well, I mean, that's just
a given. So I guess I would say if this were me, I would find another family with kids similar in age. Mm-hmm.
And drop off all the kids and then all the adults go have fun.
Or you all go in together and the adults go do their thing and the kids go do their thing.
Yep.
And you say, fuck off. Here's some money. Have fun. I don't want to deal with y'all.
Here's a prepaid cell phone. Call me.
Yeah.
When you're ready to go.
Or stay, like if you're fucking wealthy enough, stay at one of the on property things and like, here's how you get back to the hotel room. Good luck.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Is Disney worth it?
I mean, with her saying that Universal was a lot of work, I would say no in her case.
Agreed.
Disney was way more walking than Universal was.
Yeah.
Because we were clocking like 20 to 30 miles a day.
I don't know if it's that much, but
I wrote it down. Because I was wanting to be able to remember like how many miles we walked. Well, no, I didn't do miles. I did steps.
Sorry. Yeah, because I think we did about.
It was eight to ten. So the first day was 8.65 miles. Second day was 9.61 miles. Third day was 10.35, 9.01, 8.65, and 8.91.
Yeah.
So it was 9 miles.
I did find...
walking.
I found Universal a whole lot more fun than Disney. Mainly because of the crowds. But also...
and Harry Potter.
Yeah.
Because I'm a big Harry Potter fan.
Yeah. Everything was close. Yeah, everything was near... Yeah, I just enjoyed Universal better.
Yep.
And frankly, the food kind of sucked at Disney World.
Well, the places that we ate.
Yeah.
We can't say that, you know, one restaurant might have been better than what we did. We tried and we failed.
The Italian restaurant was pretty.
Yeah. Surprisingly, that's actually one of the Italian restaurant at the entrance to the Magic Kingdom. That's actually rated one of the worst restaurants in the parks.
Really?
And I liked it.
I mean,
it was
so much better than the water one that we did.
The Living Seas one. Yeah. That sucked.
Yeah.
Overpriced and very bad food.
Bland. And,
yeah. Anyway, I don't think it's worth it until they're old enough to be on their own.
Yeah.
And then even then it's like, if you're not a Disney person.
Yeah. If I ever go back to Disney, it's with no kids.
I'd go back to Disney with the kids as long as I could separate from the kids.
Well, no, cause I don't want to pay for all that.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
No, I'd go like with me, you, Zane, EJ, like all of us just have a friend's trip to Disney.
Gay old time.
That would be fucking fun.
Yeah. And drink around the world finally.
Right. Well, a lot of that was, well, in the Germany area was just beer. So it just depends on what they have. But yeah, I would just rather just go with friends.
Yeah. Agreed. So Benjamin.
Disney. 2030.
Yeah. Well, Wesley will be at boarding school probably, and Clear, she'll be old enough. You can bring her sister and you get to, you know what we should do? We should bring Ayana and make Clear responsible for her for the day.
No.
You can call me if you need help.
We should bring Kiki
and
make Kalia responsible for Ayana and Jalen for those days.
Yeah, I don't want to pay for that.
That would be birth control.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm just saying, because I mean, Ayana would be what, 20, 30,
7 years
from
nine?
Ish.
Yeah.
And then Jalen would be 7. Kalia, 16 ish, depending on when we go.
Oh, yeah.
That was so birth control.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
We have a plan.
We have a plan.
All right, Benjamin, start planning.
That's right.
All right. So, that's the last of our Reddit stories. We're already at an hour and 12.
We did good.
So for our 15 listeners, thank you so much. This has been we've had a really fun season. I hope you enjoyed it.
Yep.
Listen to us whine and bitch.
Yep. And interview people.
So, let's see. Thanks again for listening to another episode and another season of A Guide to Poor Parenting.
Yeah. If you like our podcast, please give us a 5-star rating on whatever platform you're listening on whatever platform you can.
And if you don't like our podcast, just like when our kids ask why they have to go outside and play.
Well, tough shit.
Yeah.
Go outside and play, motherfucker.
Get the fuck out of my hair.
That's right.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.